Welcome back to Crypto's Rich Boy. Today, the market is doing well. We're at $1.954 trillion. We're just half a billion away from that $2 trillion mark. Like I was talking about yesterday and the day before, because of what PayPal and Visa is doing, allowing the payments from cryptocurrency, I think we're seeing a lot of new money enter into the market. This might be our catalyst for our next part of the bull run. And as we can see with the prices today, it looks like it has been helping. So Bitcoin at 59,414, Ethereum at 1850, Binance Coin at 307, Cardano at $1.19, Polkadot at 36.87. XRP at 55 cents, Uniswap at 28.39, Litecoin at 194, and Theta at 12.27. So, coins are actually doing pretty well. It looks like we have, about half and half in the green and half in the red out of the top 10. But I mean, not too big of losses, but Polkadot has 8% gain, so that's pretty decent. Right now it is saying BTC is at 56%, 56.6% dominance. So when the dominance of the Bitcoin goes down, that means that altcoins, more money is flowing into these altcoins, and it then becomes an altcoin season. So we were at 60%, now we're at 56%. So it looks like altcoins are starting to get some spotlight. We should start to see some runs, and we should start to see some gains from all these altcoins. So today I found an article that says how cryptocurrency can inspire a new kind of financial literacy. So if you think about it, you have the traditional investments like stocks, gold, bonds, stuff of that nature. You put your money in a savings account, you might get anywhere, from a quarter of a percent, maybe if you're lucky, 1%. But for a whole year, 1%, $1,000, you get 10 bucks. That's nothing. As we can see with the cryptocurrencies, I've seen coins 10 times their self. And that was just in in my opinion, the mini part of the bull run. I think we still have the major part here to come. So it says, the article goes on to say, in the middle of the global pandemic and in the peculiar detachment of the financial markets from the economy, another oddity occurred, a sudden explosion in cryptocurrency investment. In 2020 into 2021, trading volumes hit record daily highs, and Bitcoin quadrupled as new investors flooded into the market. According to the recent study from Cornerstone Advisors, 15% of Americans now own cryptocurrency, half of whom owned for the first time last year. So you gotta think, cryptocurrency, according to the article, cryptocurrency is owned by 15% of Americans. So if you think about it, even if, I don't think we'll ever get to a point where, until it becomes the actual currency where like you can go and buy and spend it, I don't know if we're ever gonna get to a point, or I think it's gonna take a really long time for everybody to own cryptocurrency. But if you think like we're at 15% now and the market's almost at 2 trillion, so if we three times that, even if less than half at 45% of Americans own it, and you got to think that's not even including other countries. We're probably gonna be around a $6 trillion market. So for those of us in it now, it is gonna provide so much rewards and so much return on our investments because we are actually getting in at that early time. that, we are actually really, really, really lucky for those of us that are getting in now, in my opinion. It says, are digital coins the new digital gold or the next bubble? And is it wise to invest in a cryptocurrency if you aren't both financially and digitally literate? Which raises a bigger question. Are we on the path to an even greater divide in the rich and the tech savvy get richer and the poor and the less educated are getting left behind? Likely we are, but not for the reasons that you might think. So, in my opinion, I think nowadays most people are, decently tech savvy. Even my grandfather owns a smartphone. He's in his 80s. So I think nowadays, most people own smartphones, and even if they're not fully tech savvy, I think we're going to get to a point where Apple and Android are going to preload some form of cryptocurrency exchange, whether it's one that we have now or a new one, I'm not sure. But I think once that happens, which could be pretty soon, I think that even more money is going to flow into the market. And like I said, if 15% are in it now, and even if we three times that and go to 45%, which is still less than half of Americans, which I think we could five times that and go to 75%, and that would be a $10 trillion market if that was the case, if we five times the market cap right now, and if that's the case, like I said, in my opinion, Bitcoin, whether it's the end of this year or beginning of next year, I really believe it's gonna hit between 300 and 400,000. And so when that happens, there's gonna be some major gains for those of us that are currently in it right now. So let's go on. A decade in Bitcoin is reaching maturity, aided by broader acceptance from prominent fintech companies, such as a $50 million investment by Square and PayPal allowing users to buy and sell Bitcoin on the platform. Alternative cryptocurrencies are proliferating. There are now more than 4,000 or 7,000, depending on who you ask, digital currencies in the market. And a number of nations are piloting their own national cryptocurrencies, including Ecuador, China, Singapore, and Tusana, among others. And yet financial literacy remains rudimentary. In the United States, only 17% of 18 to 34-year-olds can correctly answer four of five basic financial literacy questions, and 53% feel anxious when thinking about their personal finances, according to the FINRA's State of U.S. Financial Capability Study. And yet Americans tend to think that they are more financially savvy than they are, with 71% giving themselves a high score when assessing their financial literacy. Meanwhile, less than half the states require high schools to offer financial literacy coursework. I definitely think we're going to get to a point where they will be offering, financial courses. Definitely in colleges. I know they have a lot already in colleges, but I think, and even potentially in high schools. I think, if we're able to teach those that are in high school, get them ready for like the real world, quote unquote, I think that if there is a course that's implemented, I strongly believe that Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies are gonna definitely be a part of that course. Whether it's a brief section or a whole chapter, not sure, but like I said, the second that I think, you look at Tesla getting in, and you look at PayPal getting in, and you look at BlackRock getting in, and you look at all these other financial institutions that are looking into the space. I mean, it's only a matter of time before these tech companies like Apple and Samsung and LG and different Android companies, are going to be looking at getting into the space. Once they get into the space, in my opinion, you got to imagine if everybody who bought a new phone had a way when they opened up and loaded their brand new phone and it says something about a cryptocurrency or something about an exchange and how, and they read about it and they learn how, it can, make them gains and make profits on their investment. I mean, of course they're gonna get in. I think a lot of people just don't know how to do it, how to get started. Many people that I talk to are like, hey, I want to invest, but how do I start? What, do I just go on a website or do I, what do I do? So, I think that as things are going to, I think as more adoption happens and people, especially get a brand new phone and boom, it's right there. Definitely, I think we can go, I think that number can go to 75%, if not higher, of Americans will be invested, especially if they look past in the previous gains that people have made. Now, I do think, as time goes on and those cycles go on, I think that there's going to be less gains made because the volatility is going to become less and it's going to have more stability. But I definitely think this bull market, a lot of money is to be made. And I believe the next bull market, we're gonna have a lot of money to be made. And then, in my opinion, I think the gains are gonna start, dying off and becoming kind of like the stock market, where you're happy to get 2% at any given time, and that's on a, then that'll be a good day for you. But yeah, so definitely think we have room to grow. I definitely think that, like I said, especially for the next 6 months, we're going up from here. And yeah, until next time.